Kevin De Bruyne and Raheem Sterling are both out of contract in the summer of 2023. There's full of media reports about them, you know, rightfully going and asking about a new contract, getting a healthy pay rise, which they, you know, they deserve in the sense that they've done well. But I look at the dynamic of this City team, and compared to other great teams, this really is a team in the sense that there's very few City players where you say, oh, they have to have hang on to him. You know, this isn't like Bayern and Lewandowski or Barcelona with Messi. City can go and talk to De Bruyne and Sterling and say, thank you for everything you've done. We've paid you well. We think you're worth this much. If you don't take it, it's fine. The sun's going to rise tomorrow. Nobody has that bargaining power. We thought Aguero might. We thought De Bruyne might. And then he misses a whole season. And they still beat everybody. We don't see Aguero at all this year. And they I mean, from a from a club perspective, this is an absolute luxury, right?
Yes. Yes. 100%. 100%. I think for most teams, as we've kind of seen in Liverpool and so on, when you miss key players, the team can tend to unravel. But when City were playing without Sergio Aguero and Kevin De Bruyne, who were two of the best players in the club's history, they proceeded to win every game in that spell. And it wasn't due to the talented individuals which they have. It was due to the collective performance of everybody. And that, I think, is why, you know, they're in this look, this position of luxury where a Kevin De Bruyne coming into your team gives you a big boost, but a Kevin De Bruyne out of your team isn't a massive loss. They have an ability to rotate, because I think with Pep and with his coaching staff and so on, he's got the team understanding exactly what their roles are, and they perform them almost perfectly most of the time. So when Kevin De Bruyne leaves the team, the person coming in isn't being asked to be Kevin De Bruyne. He's being asked to play the 10 in this system. And whoever comes in to do that is capable of doing so. So in some ways, it makes it harder for a De Bruyne or a Sterling, because now it's a team not based on individuals. Like you say, when you look at Messi and so on in those places, who are basically having teams built around them. But I'd ask the question, does Kevin De Bruyne want to stay at Man City? Does Raheem Sterling want to stay at Man City? Because I'm sure Man City will want them to stay. But if they believe that it's going to be a case of money or whatever, then yeah, you could go somewhere else. But how many places, especially in England right now, have the same level of ambition that Man City actually do? And I've answered probably no one. So then you look around Europe, how many teams have that level of ambition? And you start looking at maybe one or two. But are those one or two teams looking to invest in players like Sterling, like De Bruyne? And how much would it cost for them to do so? So I think sometimes, for me, you know, the players, they will get more money. The Sheikh has more money, and he values those two players greatly, same way Pep does, which is why they play all the time. But I think if they show a desire to want to stay, then they can be part of something which at the moment feels incredible. And provided Pep's still there and they still have the same mentality in 2-3 years' time, you ask yourself the question, why would you want to leave?